I was showing you how to do this neckline and I made a very, very big mistake. I didn't realize, and the camera was filming at the wrong time, so none of this got filmed, but I'm just going to go back to explain what it was that I did to get this result. It's very, very simple. Basically, all you're doing is you're centering your kameez. This is going to be a galapatti. It's going to be like a grandad collar. If you remember, I did the one similar to this. I had two outfits that I'd cut out just, I think it was just prior to Christmas. What it is, this is the front of the kameez. I've just cut a very small 3-inch depth, 3-inch across neckline. So that cut is 3 inches going all the way around. I centered this with an iron mark and then I prepared the putty. Now the putty is that I'm using is, if you watch one of my videos that I've done yesterday, this was actually on a scarf. It's in the neckline section under Banarsi trimmings, and this putty was on the butta, and I've taken it off the dupatta because I want to use it as a color contrast with the outfit that I'm currently making. Now, to make the patti into the shape of attaching it to the neckline, cut the length of the patti in your requirement. I've pulled this off the butta, so there's currently all threads hanging everywhere. So you probably constantly see me picking on the threads and pulling on them because it's a bit annoying when you're working. You want to work on a clean, you know, ideally if you do take something off like this off an existing dress, then unpick all the threads first. I'm a little bit stuck for time, so I tend to get a bit carried away, and when I do something, I want to do it quickly. Now, what you do with this is you cut it to the length that you require, so you decide whether how long depth of the neckline you want, whether you want a long neckline or you just want a short putty. An average is about 12 inches. We're going for a fairly long one. You iron this and you center mark it here. Then what you do is you turn it over, and where your iron mark is, you, that line, you center it against that iron mark and you press it again. This side of the patti, you align it with that one and you press it again, and whereas you will get your perfect V shape. Now, the edges of this do not need trimming or anything. You could do this neckline on anything. I will show you, yesterday a girl came into the shop and she had a ready-made outfit, which she was asking me whether I could do the neckline like that. Now, it was very, very, very easy. I mean, she wanted me to sew her a suit and I actually refused because I haven't got time. So, but the neckline itself was done on a chiffon, using a floral print that they'd trimmed off the bottom of the dress, and also you know, the collar. Now, it was a similar type of neckline to this, so I would probably do something like that and show you, just to give you varying ideas. Now, the one that I'm currently doing is I've shaped it like this, and then I've taken the gala, and I have pinned it on. This is the neckline that I've done. So what I basically did was laid the fabric flat. The neckline that I made, I placed it in the center here first. I pinned it in place, a couple of pins here, a couple of pins there, a couple of pins there, and just to keep it in place. And then basically what I started to do was to stitch it down all the way up to here, all the way up to here, all the way there, and all the way back. Started again, went down, and went back up. And basically that's all there is to it. I haven't cut into the neckline yet. There's a couple of things that I want to do before I actually finish this, because what I'm going to do is the center of this, I'm going to use piping, you know, and I want to use a contrasting color piping. I want it to stand out. I'm going to do this on the hemline as well. and I want the result of it to actually stand out. There's no point in doing something if you're putting effort into something, put it in wholeheartedly. You know, there's no point in doing something half, if you know what I mean. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do it wholeheartedly, and I'm actually going to you know, trim it off with a few fancy, you know, I'm going to trim it off in this maroon because I want a nice neat edging to this, because I'm going to use edging all around here and around the granddad collar. It's going to give it that total. I mean, I looked at quite a few other colors and what to contrast it off with, and then I thought, you know what, why not maroon? The most opposite color that you go on, the better the result will look. Now, I'm not going to attach the piping yet. What I will do is I will do the shoulder seams first because I've got the thread on, and I will also prepare my neckline. I'm actually doing two suits at the same time in same color, and believe it or not, what actually happened was terrible memory lapses here, and what I keep doing is I keep putting things and I keep losing them. That is so sad. The other day we lost part of a camise and I had to cut another one, and now we've just come across it. Now, on the type of neckline that we're going to do, the only thing to bear in mind is this neckline doesn't have a cut at the back, so make sure you don't cut the back of the neck, because if you do cut the back of the neck, you will not be able to do a neckline like this, because this type of necklines needs to sit on a high sort of neck. Now, the shoulder on this dress, I've just cut it slightly wide because I've trimmed into the front. So I'm going to leave a little bit. There's actually a story to this dress, and that's why it's not, I want to trim it down a little bit. Now I'm just going to attach the shoulder seams, just leaving a slight bit of fabric on either side just to balance it out, and then I will go back and relate to you the story behind this dress. So that is my shoulder seams attached, and I haven't cut into the neckline itself yet, but I will do now. So in between the seams, I'm just going to cut all the way down to where this fabric is being turned over to. So that's as far as my neckline is going to go, and that's the kind of neckline this is going to have. So it's going to have a high neckline, like a granddad collar. I'm just going to slightly cut into this because it's just a little bit small. Make sure when you cut into this, you cut them both into the same size. Ideally, place it on the table and cut so that your roundness is really the same all the way around. Now I've got to go and make my granddad collar and attach that to this, because the type of neckline that I'm going to do, I'm going to pipe this. So I'm just gonna turn the camera off for a few minutes, go and prepare my neckline, and then come back and attach that and show you how I'm going to do that.